But home is a place where young people have to be taught to carry out their share of the load. They need to experience the gratifying results of giving to others and contributing to the common good of the family and society. They must learn that in reality, amen, the world owes them nothing. Responsibility and contribution must be recognized in the home.
Yes.
And then the home should be a worship center.
Yes.
Yes. God help us. Well, Pastor, you don't know. I just don't have time. Pastor, you don't know how hard we have to work, both parties, and everybody in our home have to work. We just don't have time. Amen. But that's the reason we come to church. Oh, not hurt at all.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. We come to church to worship the Lord. Amen. One day a week.
Say it.
6 days we don't worship the Lord. I want to tell you something. The home should be a worship center.
Amen.
Amen. Worship begins as a family affair.
Amen.
I know this is all sounds strange to the society in which we live. I know that this teaching don't give this anymore. Well, it's a dog eat dog world. Everybody's so busy, and you just don't have. I know you're trying to make a living in Montgomery County, one of the highest counties in the United States, and you have to work two jobs to make ends meet. When you get home, you're dead tired. You have to go back, get a little rest, and go back to the same old thing tomorrow. You know that over 70% of people that work on jobs, they hate their job. Even though it is a necessity, even though they know they have to work to make ends meet and pay the bill, but you ask them, really ask them, I say, well, I hate my job. What can we do as a church to help families?
Help us,
set a good example, a Christian example. That's a good start right there.
Amen.
You see, in the Old Testament, the father served as the priest.
Yes.
And worship was conducted in the home. Yes. The children were taught the ways and works of God by their parents, and the sacrifices were made by the father on the family altar. You remember I read out of Deuteronomy chapter 6, and it talks about, amen, amen, that writing them down and teaching them to our children, amen, in the home, on the door place, everywhere we go, we have that responsibility.
Yes, yes,
God help us today, hallelujah. You see, there's an urgent need for the recovery of the priesthood of parents.
Amen.
Nothing takes the place of family worship.
That's right, amen.
The parents who take the time to make the effort to have Bible reading and prayer with their children will find a unity and a solidarity which cannot be achieved through any other means. You see, now, please don't you get mad at me. Don't throw your shoe at me.
Preach the word, preach. It's God's word. Preach.
Some parents have the idea, that the church is solely responsible for the spiritual development of their children.
Not so.
This is not true. If worship is not given a place of prominence and importance at home, Lord, can you just think, it becomes a Herculean task to make it meaningful in church.
Amen.
Not only Silver Spring Church of God, but so many times when we can see, like this morning, God moving in our midst in a mighty way. We have some beautiful young people. I'm not talking about our young people, just Silver Spring. But many of our young people, they just sit there like they're ready to go to sleep.
Yeah.
and just sit there and just follow. God can be moving in a miraculous way. Why are they sitting there?
That's right, absolutely, amen.
Somebody said, well, it's not relevant. They need to be down in the children's church. I'm going to tell you, we start worshiping the Lord, amen, from a total up to, amen, a toddler, up to a young person. You'll recognize the power of God.
Take your time.
Go ahead.
Home must be a place, or should be a social center.
Amen.
Now think about that. Let that sink in. This is where a young person in your family learn to live in group life. As a group, you see. Good social adjustment must begin in the home.
Amen.
Good social adjustments.
Yeah. Yes.
You see, the home is a place where we learn about different personalities and cultures and people. You see, as the young person relates himself to other members of the family, he should be acquiring skills which will help him to meet the social expectancies of group situations. Hallelujah. You see, in his home, experienced parents should strive to build mature patterns for dealing with people. Amen. By healthy family relationship.
Amen.
Plan family fellowship.
Yes.
Wholesome group activity.
Yes.
And ample opportunity for meaningful experience beyond the family circle.
Amen.
Learning, amen, social skills.
Yes.
In the home, amen.
Yes.
The home should be a center of democratic action. It should foster creative rather than resentful responses to social obligations. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. It is here that the young person should learn how to come out of isolation and live in a community of sharing and cooperation.
Amen.
We can follow you today.
Yes.
See, parents, You and I as parents should be concerned about the youth's social contacts beyond the home.
Yes. Amen.
Wholesome group experiences, activities, and interests should be sought to replace and overcome negative contacts which may occur. While no young person can be shielded from all undesirable contact, parents can see that this exposure is minimal and controlled. Amen?
Amen.
Are you with me?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Then, last but not least, I could say a lot of other things here, but I hear where you are. I see where you are. Home must be a place to learn about what life and love. Life and love.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Now, that comes under social skills as well.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
You see, you take the physical development of our young people. Puberty is what between age what? It all depends on the gender, right?
Yes.
Girls' puberty begins at what? 12?
Uh-huh.
And then boys' puberty begins what? At 14. And then you got your, your adolescence growing up, your childhood into maturity. So you see all these developments that take place in the home. How do we as believers treat that? Amen. In other words, it is evident fact that one of the major problems facing young people in their adjustment is the area of sex.
That's right.
Whether we like it or not,
that's right.
There is a sex revolution in our
day. Say it. Amen.
Amen. You see, the old rules are being challenged.
Right.
And there is increasing evidence of a new morality, amen, that's here today.
Yes.
Amen. It is apparent that somewhere someone needs to educate teenagers in the significance of sex, the meaning of marriage, and the reality of life and love.
Amen.